Hey, badass business owners, it's Tammy and I'm back for a few minutes to talk about something that's really, really important and I really need you to embrace it. And that is that your time has value. I can't tell you how many times I'm talking to small business owners and what they do is they price out their products or their service. And then what they do is they just take whatever money's left. They put the money in the pocket and they take it, but they fail to account in their cost of goods, their time. Well, your time is valuable. Whether you are installing it, whether you are making it, whether you are spending hours sitting there crocheting it, putting it together, spending hours putting the right ingredients together, putting your heart into whatever it is that you deliver to people, your time is worth something. And it's probably one of the biggest things that people struggle with when they are pricing out their products or their services, because it feels weird to them to price something at a certain level. But at the same time, if it took you 3, 4, 5 hours to put this thing together or to make it, well, guess what? That is part of the value of it. So instead of selling 20 of them making $5, maybe you might sell 10 of them making $35 plus more, because you're actually including your time. And this is a huge problem that people have, is that when we're talking about their pricing, it rarely includes their time. And part of your cost of goods is two things. If it's a service or something you create and you make and you are part of that, it is part of cost of goods, the time that it takes. And you're going to pay yourself a fair wage to do that. That might be $10, $15, $20, $25. Depends on whatever it is that you're doing. If you were to hire someone off of the streets to do that, you deserve the exact same thing. The problem is you don't realize what you're paying yourself because you're taking all the money at the end and not dividing it out by the hours that you make. And if you don't look, and I'm telling you, sometimes the math is horrible. There are people that literally will make $3, $5. Sometimes people are doing it for free and they're not even making a profit. Forget the business profit for a minute. You're not even making money as the business owner. All right, because you're failing to account for your time. And that's why it's so important that you account for your time as part of this entire thing. I'm going to continue to do more videos on pricing, and I'm going to continue to do more on trying to help you understand that you've got to account for your time when you are putting your prices together. So there's a right way to do it and a wrong way to do it. Sometimes it's very straight up. You might say, okay, I'm going to go do this service. It takes me 2 hours to do it. Boom, that's my time. But for some of you, you might batch things. You might make 5, 6, 10 things in one sitting and you're like, oh my God, I don't know how to do this. It took me 3 hours, but I made 10 of them. Great, it's 3 hours divided by 10. Each of those 10 are gonna be responsible for a certain number of minutes of that job, okay? So we'll continue to do more and more on this. I've got a video coming out in the next few days that's gonna talk about this a little bit more, and I'm gonna continue to do that. Listen, the biggest thing I need you to do is I need you to understand that your time and your business is valuable. It is probably the most precious commodity you have. It's very limited. And the first thing I got to get you to do is to pay yourself correctly for the doing piece of your business. When you are an employee of your business, remember, you wear two hats, the employee hat and the business owner hat. And it's important that you understand that just because there's money at the end of the sale doesn't mean it's business money. It means it's employee money first to pay yourself. Anything above and beyond that is when you've created a business that's making money. All right. So please know that your time is valuable. Later in your business, you start to find out that your time is more valuable than $10, $15. So we want you to get away from doing employee things and getting more into business owner things. And that's where you hire somebody to replace you in the business. And if you're not accounting for that time up front, that's what gets people in trouble, because all of a sudden they're giving up their employee money to this new employee and they've got no money because they never thought to get the business to be profitable in the first place. So we'll talk more about this. I'm going to get out of here. I'm rattling on too much and I got to be somewhere. So bye.